Hello everyone. Today we will talk and learn about the Tinker Guide. Tinker Guide is a free online collection of a software. It helps us to think, create and make. And believe me, this is one of the best online available resource. So to access a Tinker Guide, you simply open a website of a Tinker Guide, sign up. For the first time user, sign in if you are existing users. Then you will end up on a dashboard. Here you can have all the options, whether you want to tinker related with the 3D design, you want to create a 3D design, or you want to make any prototype related to the circuit, or you want to try a code blocks related to the coding. And in case you are new on this particular website, then you can follow the lessons also. So let me brief you first all the features available on this particular website, the features and the buttons, tricks, how to use it. So let's start with the circuit. So first click on a create a new circuit. So we are at this circuit. This is the workspace. So before starting, let me brief you about the tools available over here. Here, if you can see my arrow, so these are the tools which will be required during any circuit assembly. Here all the basic components are there, and if you want to read more about the component or the little bit info about the component, you can click on the list view, and here in the list view you can have all the basic information related with the component. So you can see all the component. So first tab is related with the general component, then the input component like a push button or a slider switch, right? Then the sensors, almost all kind of sensors you will find here, all the dip switch, then the output devices like a LED or the RGB light bulb, right? NeoPixel. Also you are having a microcontroller here, the power related things, breadboard, and all the instruments, a digital multimeter or a power supply or a variable power supply, oscilloscope, all the circuits or the microcontroller as I said, then the power controllers. So you will find almost everything related to electronics components on this particular site. Okay, so now let's create one simple circuit. So let me show you or demo you how to create a connection, and the same time we will learn about all the tools available over here. So I am creating a circuit to, you know, on the LED. So here I selected one LED and a battery. So by using this rotation tool, I can rotate the component. Let's say now let me make the connection between the LED and cell, right? The connection is done. So by clicking on a simulation, I can check whether my connection is working or not. Okay, my connection is working, LED is on with some information, as there was the current is higher side, right? As there is a no resistance was put in between, so the life of this LED will be reduced. So what we can do, we can put a resistance in between. So let me change the connection. Okay. Now let's see. So there is a no message over here that's going through. The same time, we can also change the value of a resistance. You can select by clicking on the resistance, and you can select the value as per required in your circuit, right? So this is one example of a simple circuit, right? The similar, now let's create little bit complex circuit using the breadboard and all. And if you want to delete, you can click and delete. If you want to save the project, you can save the project also. Okay, so let's try one more circuit. So I'm going to create one analog piano, right? So I will brief you all the shortcuts in between. So for that I required a breadboard, then registers and a push button, right? Then a buzzer, a capacitor and a buzzer, right? So you can also type rather than searching the things, right? Now for I need a multiple resistance, so rather selecting a multiple times, I can use the shortcut as a control C and then control V, right? Then we required a multiple push buttons, so I can copy it and control V, right? And to rotate it, either we can use the tool on the screen or either we can use by pressing a R button. So the R will be rotate. So let's start the placement of all the component on the breadboard. So as per our circuit diagram, we are placing all the component. Here we are putting all the resistance, placing in the series, and the 555 timer. And once this all will be kept, then we will go for the interconnection. Right. Now let's make the wiring. So to form wiring, you simply required to select, you know, the pin and the wiring required in between. Okay. So we are connecting in the series, right? So these are wiring. This is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can also check all the terminals here. Like one is belongs to the ground, then trigger, out, reset, right? So reset, we have to make one, you know, power connection between the reset. Okay, let's change the color to the red as it's from the positive terminal, right? Then we have to connect the buzzer. So let me rotate it. So one terminal will be on a negative, the positive will be on the top. So let's connect this like this. Okay. Then we have a capacitor. Right. So capacitor in between point 1 and 2. Then let's short the board with the power. So this is the negative. So let's change the color to black. This one is a positive. So let's change the color to the red, right? This is towards the power. Okay, so we had okay, one connection is left between the threshold to the trigger, right? So that the delay can be the we can get. So one, okay, let me change this. We can put this later on, post this connection. Now let's check all the connections. Okay, we have resistors in series, the terminations, Now we require a battery to connect the power source. So this 9 volt battery, let me rotate it. Positive. Change the color. Negative. Change the color to black. And here also I'm changing the color so that this is connected with our buzzer. Okay. This one with the gray. Okay, so now we are having all the points, terminals, right? Let's again review our circuit. Okay, so let's have a overview of the component which we used. One is the resistors, right? So resistors, the way we are using, so we used in the series, right? So that the current remain the same, right? And voltage can be add up so that we can have this 555 timer with respect to the voltage and the current. We can have the modulation of the sound and the pulse can be controlled by the 555 timer. The another component which we use is a buzzer, right? So it's used for the sound and all, as you are aware, and also a 555 timer. So here are the, you know, the diagram of the 555 timers. If you can recall, this discharge was connected with the trigger to control the pulse, or I can say the to control, like we are having a capacitor on here. So that capacitor and the trigger, we can have the connections so that the internal transistor can be, you know, sync up with respect to the timer, and we can have the expected output, right? The reset to control all the process is connected with the positive source, right? While this threshold is required, it's the on the positive side, and this control voltage we did not use in our circuit, and the VCC supply is connected, right? So these are the pin diagram.